After 9 years of operations, CNN Philippines announced it will stop its operations on all of its media platforms, citing massive financial losses. Our correspondent Jackie Pascual now joins us with details. Jackie, what more can you tell us?
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. CNN Philippines shuts down effective Wednesday, January 31, 2024, with its last live airing earlier today. The company said it will discontinue its news production operations on all media platforms as a result of financial losses. CNN Philippines is a franchise holder of the CNN International brand, and they pay licensing fee to the global media giant. At the head office of CNN Philippines here in Mandaluyong, employees attended the General Assembly this morning where company officials, led by its president, Benjamin Ramos, officially announced the closure. He thanked the staff for their service for the past 9 years. Some employees say that they will be given a separation pay within the day, while others have already begun looking for a new job. Sources also add, Carmina, that a few or a select few employees will be extended for at least a month for transition purposes. CNN Philippines, aired on the RPN frequency, is owned and operated by the Nine Media Corporation with a brand licensing deal with Warner Brothers Discovery. Carmina, I'm still here outside the office of CNN Philippines in Mandaluyong as we gather more updates on this development. In the afternoon, the employees are expected to return back to get supposedly to get their checks for the separation pay this afternoon. And that's the latest from Mandaluyong. Back to you, Carmina.
All right, Jackie, a couple of questions for you before we let you go. I mean, there have been talks before today that there was something that's going to happen to CNN Philippines. When you talk to the employees affected by this shutdown, were they aware that this day was going to come, or did it come as a surprise?
Carmina, many of the employees I've talked to were surprised by what happened. They first heard of the news of the closure from social media and from news articles, not from their official government bosses. Today, the General Assembly earlier was the first time that the officials officially told them about the said closure. And some of the employees said some were crying inside, but many were also optimistic that they can find a new job. Carmina.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that. Our love to all of our colleagues there at the CNN Philippines newsroom. Jackie Pascual there joining us on the line. Thanks again, Jackie. Motorists are in for another round of oil price hikes Tuesday in what the Energy Department described as the biggest yet for this year. Gasoline will see the biggest jump of 2 pesos and 80 centavos per liter, while diesel will have a 1 peso and 30 centavo increase. A liter of gasoline will also go up by 45 centavos. The DOE earlier cited the lower U.S. crude stock for the hike in pump prices. The Anti-Money Laundering Council warns the public against a scheme where scammers send fake certifications to make it appear the victim's bank accounts have been subjected to a freeze order by the AMLC. One victim received a document which indicated a freeze order for alleged terror financing. The Dirty Money Watchdog leader found the document to be a counterfeit. The agency urges individuals who have received similar documents to contact its office for clarification. The Philippines is hoping to exit the Financial Action Task Force's gray list of jurisdictions under increased monitoring for dirty money risks by October this year. Well, three American troops killed and dozens more injured following a drone attack on U.S. forces stationed in Jordan. This marks the first time U.S. troops were killed in the area since the Israel-Hamas war broke out in October. U.S. President Joe Biden blaming Iran-backed militant groups, he vows to hold them responsible.
I want to point out that we had a tough day last night in the Middle East. We lost three brave souls in an attack on one of our bases.
Yes.
And I'd ask you for a moment of silence for all three of those fallen soldiers.
Jeez.
And we shall respond. God bless you all. Thank you for allowing me to be here. And I wish you didn't have to go. Thank you all so very much.
On X, U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin said he's outraged and deeply saddened by the deaths of the American soldiers. An analyst believes the deaths of three U.S. service members in Jordan could lead to a further escalation of tensions in the Middle East. Laura James of Oxford Analytica says the U.S. will have to respond even more strongly than it has to previous attacks that will possibly kill top Iraqi and Iranian militia leaders.
This is a very important escalatory step. It's in some ways, it's what we've been worrying about for the past several weeks, and to some extent for the last couple of months, in that US casualties was always seen as a red line. US deaths in all of these attacks that we've seen on various US interests, US bases, minor injuries, people targeted who weren't actually US citizens. This is the tipping point. So three US soldiers' deaths is important. It's not necessarily a tipping point into uncontrolled escalation between the United States and Iran, but it's another very dangerous step because, as I say, the US will have to respond even more strongly than it's done to previous attacks. That means possibly killing some very, very senior Iraqi militia leaders, possibly some senior Iranians.
Japan joins other countries in suspending funding to the UN Agency for Palestinian Refugees. This following Israeli allegations, some UNRWA staff took part in Hamas's October 7 attack. The agency has fired several personnel over the accusations and promised a thorough investigation into the claims. Israel, meanwhile, has vowed to stop the agency's work in Gaza after the war. Several top donors, including the United States and Germany, have halted funding to the agency, which has been at the heart of humanitarian efforts in Gaza. In Paris, climate change activists hurl soup at the world-famous Mona Lisa painting in the Louvre Museum. The soup only hit the protective glass in front of the painting. The activists represented the French organization called Food Response, which said the protests sought to highlight the need to protect the environment and food sources. Many activists have recently targeted art to raise awareness about climate change. Other targets include Vincent van Gogh's sunflowers in London and a Monet painting in Sweden. After Wednesday, Jenna Ortega stars in the new psychological drama Miller's Girl. But is the film worth your time and money? Manny, the movie guy, has the answer.
Sweet.
Jenna Ortega, fresh from the success of Netflix's Wednesday, becomes a seductive vixen in the psychological drama / quasi-sociological thriller Miller's Girl.
What is an adult?
She's Cairo Sweet, a high school student too smart for her age, and sets her sights on her creative writing professor, Jonathan Miller, played by Martin Freeman.
Don't you get scared walking through those woods?
Ortega, who grew up in Palm Springs, recently visited the desert for the movie's premiere at the Palm Springs International Film Festival.
The topic of the film is a little bit riskier, a little bit something that, you know, it's a scary thing to, you know, approach.
Speechless. Yes, the topic of Miller's Girl is risky, teacher and student sexual affair, and I don't blame you if you judge the film based on the subject matter. It's asking for it, but look closely and you'll see a coming-of-age story about consequences and complicity.
Even worse.
Written and directed by Jade Holly Bartlett, the film can be seen as a fiction writer's dream. There are many references to popular novels and their themes.
I don't know.
Like the character of Cairo Sweet, the film can be too smart for its own good and a bit confused on how to close. But at least the chosen ending is ultimately satisfying.
She'd open her mouth to say something.
Freeman is good as a perplexed teacher, and Ortega is having fun with her role. But the scene stealer here is Gideon Adlon, who plays Ortega's best friend, Winnie. She gives the film its much-needed levity.
You're saying in color.
My verdict? Smart and effective. Watch the film for Jenna Ortega, but stay for Gideon Adlon.
You're gonna ruin his life.
For that, Miller's Girl gets 3 out of 4 Lolita kisses. I'm Manny the Movie Guy for ABS-CBN News.